If you want to get from a terminal like this, or this, to something more like this, keep watching. I get asked from time to time about my terminal configuration, like how do you set up these timestamps, arrows in prompt and other things. And I like to provide you, my viewers, with things you are interested in. So let me show you what I use and how to set it up. Welcome. So how to get from terminal like this to this? It might seem at first like some kind of guru voodoo magic, but actually it's not that hard and everyone can do it, even beginners. And it will work on almost any kind of computer you have at your disposal, from PCs to Macs to my beloved single board computers like Raspberry Pi. So let's up your terminal game and do this step by step. First of all, change the shell from Bash to ZSH. Most today's operating systems come with Bash pre-installed and used as the default shell, but ZSH is more interactive and customizable, has more advanced features and in my view surpasses Bash on every corner. And I personally like it more. I'm going to demonstrate this on Ubuntu 22.04, but I'm sure if you're using Fedora or any other distro, you will be able to follow along. On macOS, your best friend for installing these things will be Homebrew. The link to it will be in the description. So, here's my default Ubuntu terminal. Let's check which shell are we using right now. Echo shell. As you can see, we're using the Bash shell. Let's install ZSH shell. Sudo apt install zsh. A little tidbit of terminal knowledge. When you encounter yes-no questions in terminal like this one, have you ever wondered why one of the letters is in uppercase? Well, it's the default answer if you just press enter. So I'll just hit enter and yes is sent as the answer. zsh --version to confirm everything went well and make it default shell like this. Change shell -s, which zsh. And let's check everything works as expected. We need to close this window and log out of the system. And log back in. The default shell for our user should now be zsh. Let's open a terminal and echo the shell variable again. Okay, that's correct. We are using zsh now. One of the best things about zsh is the ohmyzsh framework. Ohmyzsh builds upon zsh functionality and enables us to do literally wonders with our shell by putting in very little effort. Okay, we need to have a few prerequisites installed so the ohmyzsh can be downloaded and works properly. They are probably installed by default, but let's check anyway. Sudo apt install curl wget and git. And I'll add few more I use often. Vim text editor, MC, aka Midnight Commander. It might remind some of you the time before Windows even existed. HTOP for resource and process monitoring, and NeoFetch, a system information tool. Okay, and copy this command to install the ohmyzsh framework. It's quite a quick process, and you will see this colorful ohmyzsh is now installed message soon, with some additional information about backing up your config file and using the template file for a default configuration. Not important right now. What is important right now is that we have a foundation on which we can build our awesome terminal. You can see that a few changes already happened, like the prompt is different, this arrow and tilt are new. In fact, this design is part of the Ruby Russell theme, the default theme in ohmyzsh. And we can and will go even further. I'd like to show you the theme and plugins I like to use with my ohmyzsh. My favorite theme is the Power Level 10K theme. It's beautiful and it's simple. So how do we install it? It's as simple as this one-liner. Just copy this into your terminal and hit enter. It will download the theme and now we just activate it by editing the .zshrc file in your home directory. vim.zshrc, locate the zsh theme line and put in the powerlevel10k/powerlevel10k name. What is strongly recommended in the documentation is the use of the MISLO font. It's linked directly from the GitHub page. It's simple as downloading the files, double-clicking them and hitting that install button. After that, in the GNOME terminal, just go to preferences and pick the font in your profile. Simple as that. Restart the terminal and voila, the theme is active. On the first run, PowerLevel 10K configuration wizard will ask you a few questions and configure your prompt. I'll skim through it real quick now, but you should take your time and tune it to your liking. The theme is active, configured, and you can tell by seeing these new things like time at the end of the line. Look, if you change the directory to a Git repo, you can see the branch name shown here, nice icons representing the system, and there's more and more to this theme. I encourage you to dive deeper into ZSH and ohmyzsh. They are just wonderful. Okay, let's go one step further down the rabbit hole. I want to show you a few plugins that make my life in Terminal easier. They come pre-packed with ohmyzsh, so the only thing we need to do is to activate them. Once again, open the .zshrc file, vim.zshrc, and locate the plugins line. There's Git already, so let's just add a few more. You can find a list of available plugins here on GitHub. I'll paste the links to the description. So the ones I use often are aliases, Ubuntu, systemadmin, sudo, history, VS Code, Git, Docker, Docker Compose, and Ansible. You choose those that suit you the most, of course. Save the file and close it. Restart the terminal and we are good to go. Let me show you a few use cases. The history plugin lets us easily search our terminal history. So if you want to find all the commands I already used containing, let's say, curl, I'll just do hs as history search, curl, and I can instantly see all the commands I've used containing curl. Let's do one more. ALS is a command that is part of the aliases plugin, and it will show you all the aliases enabled at this moment. You can see there are a few. Oh, and I need to show you this one with sudo. It's so helpful. If you look at its docs, it says it will prefix your current or previous command with sudo if you press escape twice. I forget to use sudo a lot. This is such a lifesaver. Look, let's try to do the apt update without root privileges. Of course, it won't work, but I just hit escape twice, and bam, the last command prefixed with sudo waiting for me to confirm it with enter. You won't realize how much you missed it until you start using it. And one more thing. What I like to do is to set my terminal transparent a bit so I can read what's behind it, if I ever have the need. Just a tiny bit. And that's it. You have a ZSH shell with ohmyzsh framework running using the power level 10k theme with a bunch of plugins. I think this looks much better and I bet you will find it much more convenient to work with. And as a bonus, I want to show you how to configure Putty SSH client to work nicely with all of this. Many of you will be connecting to your servers or SBCs remotely like I do. So, it's just two settings. Open your Putty. In the window appearance, change the font to the same one the theme uses, so mislow.lgs. And in connection data, set the terminal type string to putty-256color. This way, you will come close enough to the look and feel of the native terminal. Pretty cool, right? Okay, that's it. I hope this video helped some of you. If it did, please consider subscribing to my channel. See you.